The former economic advisor to the late President Michael Sata, Posiame, has disclosed that the vision of the Patriot Front PF government does not only seek to modernize the country with industries and link it to the market, but also to make the country food secure. He says that the PF government, in the latest manifesto, the PF has chosen agriculture industry as a channel towards accessing desired goal, and it is through accessing the industrialization that the proposed goal will be realized. Posiame was speaking to journalists at the PF Interactive Forum, which was held on 25th April 2021 in Lusaka to discuss agriculture sector in the country.
As to the Vision 2030, which talks about creating wealth and jobs for the people. That's what the PF manifesto is talking about, creating a middle income, which we've already attained, and surpassing that. That's what the PF manifesto is talking about. So as we modernize and industrialize, we'll be moving towards the attainment of the Vision 2030.
And speaking at the same function, Professor Nakandu Luo told journalists that agriculture cannot work well without proper infrastructure development. We seek to promote interlink agriculture to other sectors that seek to promote activities, that seek to promote industries. And it was for this reason that the decision to link Zambia with various infrastructures was for the purpose of these interlinkages that seek to add value to the goods and services.
Without road infrastructure, without rail infrastructure and their infrastructure, then we are not doing anything. And this is why our infrastructure chapter is very clear. Because we are the only country, believe it or not, read anywhere, which is bordered by 8 countries, physically. And also, it's bordered by 2 other countries. We are separated by water, Lake Tanganyika. So you can imagine the decision that PF made to link Zambia, what that means for agriculture. Because we have to export our products, isn't it? And we have to import in some of the products that are critical in doing certain things. For example, the production of fish feed, stock feed, and so on. So, rail, road, air infrastructure is critical to all this. And this is why we want to build on the success that we have done.
She also called for skills building to help growth of the economy of the country. The
cultural sector will only flourish if we build on our achievements in terms of transport and road and rail infrastructure that we have started. We have to continue and continue the transformation agenda of this country so that we can draw the economies of other countries. Because the other countries will be coming here to say they would like us to export.
Margaret Chota, Movie TV News in Lusaka.